motherfuckers, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Corrielle, so that's Corrielle or Corrielle. And if you are not new here, you already knew my name, I just reminded you so you never forget it. But thanks so much for coming back for another video. I'm very happy to have you here. Ignore the little my elastic band. I'm waiting on for my lace to lay down before I take it off and finish my hair. So we're just gonna go with it because I'm on a time crunch today, but it's going on 2 weeks and I ain't putting a video out, so I need to put out some new stuff. I feel like a fucking Cuban like father, like a fucking rich ass Cuban father. Okay, let me hurry up and get into this video. All right, so these are just some topics that have just crossed my mind randomly the last few days as I'm learning and just kind of, you know, like getting rid of the old shit that doesn't align with who I am now, right? Like self-improvement and shit like that. And so I realized that this is something that I stopped doing, but I felt like I should make a video about it because some people may have heard about, like heard this before, but not had it explained to them in a way where they can understand why they should do this and how to apply it. So anyways, with the video, oh fuck, I got concealer all over the freak. I forgot I had concealer on the back of my bronzer palette and put it face down on my desk. Got to be more careful. Hold on, y'all. Ugh, this is so ghetto. Yeah, so this video is just about stop telling people your plans. Stop telling people your business. Stop telling people about your dreams and your goals and shit. When I say people, this can be in regards to friends, family, associates, co-workers, hell, even your bosses, people like your mentors and shit. Like, you got to know which stuff is okay to talk about and tell people and which stuff should be kept to yourself. I feel like if it's something that hasn't fully like manifested yet, or if it's something that you're planning on, or something that is like intimate and important to you, it shouldn't be told to nobody else. Like, you don't have to tell everybody everything about you. Number one, they don't give a fuck anyway. Like, let's just call it what it is. Like, everybody got their own life, their own problems, their own drama, their own successes and shit like that. So like, I feel like it's become a good conversational, like an easy like question to ask in conversation, like, oh, how you been, what's been going on with you and shit like that. But usually people just be like, oh wow, may ask a little question here and there and shit like that, but it's not like it's really like changing anything about them, you know what I mean? Like, it's you. Like, they can't do anything with the information. So like, just know to a certain extent, like, you don't have to tell people everything about you, because 9 times out of 10 they don't really give a fuck anyway. Like, if it's good, then yeah, like, they may be happy for you and stuff, but it's not like they need to know. You know what I'm saying? Like, they can't do anything with the information, no way. That's number one. Number two is, and I ain't even say I'm finna get right into the tips. I'm just gonna fucking go with it, y'all. The evil eye is real, okay? So you might be talking to somebody, and that's why I say this can be in regards to family, friends, hell, it don't matter, like, who it is. This is in regards to whoever you're talking to. The evil eye is real, and it can come from anybody. Like, people can and will send you negative energy towards what you're telling them or in your life, period, based on what you're telling them. Like, even if it's good or bad. And that evil eye shit will affect your energy, too. And you won't realize it. Like, you ever notice how sometimes you, like, people be like, oh, I don't want to jinx it or something like that. If they say something that's not going, that hasn't happened yet, but they just speak it out into existence to people thinking that they speaking it into existence. Whole time, somebody could be jealous of you. Somebody could be like irritated or something like that, like anything, and their negative energy then came your way and then put the little fizzle out. You didn't even let it spark into a big fire yet. You done went off telling people your business, telling people your plans, telling people your goals, and now it ain't even gonna go nowhere because they done fucking sent the shadow or the water or whatever it is and put the little fizzle out with their energy. And it's like, we have free will, we have control and shit like that, so if it's meant for you, it's gonna like grow. But like, don't tell people everything. People be jealous, and that shit does, that energy comes towards you, especially if you pure in intention, like, and you don't like send out bad energy, all your energy is pure. Like, sometimes pure energy, I feel like, has to fight a little bit harder, especially against darkness. Okay, let's say, for instance, it's something good that you planning on, doing, or that you planning on getting, or that you trying to achieve, that's a big goal or something. Or you know what I'm saying? Or that you already achieved. They can be jealous of that. But on the flip side of that, even if they're not jealous, sometimes people will, if you're venting to somebody, that's why I say this pertains to your business too. If you venting to somebody, telling people what's going on with you, how you feeling, like how you've been down and out, or whatever the fuck the case may be, especially like that, in that case is like that though, sometimes that evil eye energy can translate as them being like getting a little bit of joy out of seeing you down or something. Like they feel like more, like they feel good in a way. And sometimes it'll be like, oh, they feel like they're closer to you, but in actuality, like they want to see you down. Like even if it's people that is close to you, some people like to see people get knocked off their high horse, right? Because they're jealous. Like that's what I'm saying. Y'all need to be telling people everything about y'all, even if about you. If it's good, if it's bad, let them see it. You know what I'm saying? Like, and then let them ask you about it and just be selective in what you're telling people. Because now all that shit, like of venting and trying to tell people and ask for advice and shit like that, like no, like that will taint your energy. Hopefully it taints your energy with more positive energy if they have good intentions for you, you know what I'm saying? And you know for a fact that they're not like that, because then it'll just add with yours and then it'll just grow, and you'll have, because of support, love and shit like that, and then of course that grows. But most of the time it ain't like that. It ain't like that most of the time. So just keep it to yourself, okay? My next tip number three. Not everybody is trustworthy, okay? Especially when it comes to like ideas and plans and goals and shit like that. People will steal your idea. People will try to take your idea, take your concept, take whatever and flip it and use it for themselves. And then you be left out in the dust because somebody else did your shit. You should have just let them see it. You know what I'm saying? Like, people will try to, like, backstab you is really what I'm trying to say. And that's why it's better that if they don't know much about you, because it's like you're cutting off people's, or you're limiting people's ability to do harm to you by keeping yourself keeping your information private is what I'm trying to say. Yeah. And then not even just them not being trustworthy. Sometimes people will try to talk you out of something because they don't have good intentions for you. That also just directly correlates with them not being trustworthy. Like, you can't trust somebody that doesn't want to see you do good. You know somebody don't want to see you do good if they constantly trying to tell you all the good ideas and the shit that you feel good about and you feel passionate about and you feel like positively charged to. They trying to tell you why you shouldn't do it, why you shouldn't do this, why you can't do that, why it won't work. That person ain't good for you. That could be jealousy too. That could be evil eye energy too, but they damn sure ain't good. You damn sure don't need to be telling somebody. If somebody, every time you tell somebody about something that you was thinking about doing or trying and they come up with an excuse or come up with a reason why it won't work, then you don't need to be telling nothing to that person. You don't even need to be associating with that person for real, but damn sure don't be telling them nothing. Hello, somebody. Oh, and then back to tip number three. People will tell your business too. If you didn't already know that, people will tell your business. Even if it's to like especially with girls and you, if you in a friend group, I'd stop telling my friends that, like, if I know that they are part of friend groups and stuff, I don't tell nobody my business, because it's always gonna be somebody that's closer to somebody else than they are to you. And at that point, they can tell your business, even if it's just to their friend or their best friend or they this or they that. But the point of the matter is, like, you don't want nobody telling your business. If I'm telling my business to somebody, I want it to stay with that person that I'm telling it to. And it shouldn't leave your mouth. Because when anybody tell me their business, it don't leave my mouth. And I expect the same. But not everybody is like that. So stop telling people what's going on with you and what you planning and shit like that. Because 9 times out of 10, you really don't even know for a fact if that shit is staying with them. Then you look up and now everybody else all in your business and you done confided in one person to try to avoid that, and it then defeated the purpose. Just keep it to yourself. Keep it to yourself. All right, and I swear this is the last tip. Tip number 4/5, since I went back and added that last little part about people will tell your business. The reason why you really shouldn't be telling people everything about you too is because they don't deserve to know you that much. Like, I'm really realizing that less is more. And being intriguing and mysterious is sexy, especially for women. Like, I take pride in the fact that I can control how much people know about me, and I can control what you know and what I show you. You know what I mean? Like, I take pride in that because it's like, ooh, like, people automatically want to know about who you are. They automatically want more information on you. Like, oh, well, shit, we don't know nothing about her. Like, shit, I want to get to know her. She's so, like, mysterious. He's so mysterious. Like, what they got going on? They always quiet. I'll never hear nothing about them. I just see them. Yeah, that's how it's supposed to be. That's how it's supposed to be. Like, people don't deserve to know you that much. They don't deserve to know all your information like that. You deserve to be able to be your own person, walking your own journey and path, and calling the shots. If you want people to know, then they should know. But, like, if not, if they don't need to know, then they don't need to know. And you got to know the difference between what that information is and what it isn't in your life. So, yeah, those are the tips on why you should stop telling people all your business and stop telling people your plans and shit like that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. And yeah, that's it. See y'all in the next one. Bye.